loudly. Reporters complain that they cannot hear. Longhand and shorthand. Without looking up from their notebooks. Loose in his boots. Professor McNew. From the festival, coughs and calls. Cough it up, man. Get it out and dip. The cross-examination proceeds re-boom in the bucket. A large bucket, boom himself, foul trouble, in Beaver Street. Right, yes, quite bad. A plaster is picking, by walking stiff leg, suffering untold misery, deadly agony. About noon, carrot JW near Burgundy. Yes, some spinach, crucial moment. He did not look in the bucket. Nobody. Rather a mess. Not completely. The tidbits back number. Uproar and cat calls. He's moon in a torn frock coat stained with whitewash. Pink silk hat sideways on his head. A strip of sticking plaster across his nose. Toxinotomy. J. J. Omaloy. In barrister's gray wig and stuffed gown, speaking with a voice of pained protest. This is no place for indecent levity at the expense of an erring mortal disguised in winter. We are not in a bear garden nor at an Oxford rag nor is this. 439 a travesty of justice. My client is an infant, a poor foreign immigrant who started scratch as a stowaway and is now trying to turn an honest penny. The trumped-up misdemeanor was due to a momentary aberration of heredity, brought on by hallucination, such familiarity with the alleged guilty occurrence being quite permitted in my client's native place, the land of the Pharaoh. Prima facie. I put it to you that there was no attempt at carnally knowing. Intimacy did not occur and the offense complained of by Bristol, that her virtue was solicited, was not repeated. I would deal in especial with atavism. There have been cases of shipwreck and somnambulism in my client's family. If the accused could speak, he could a tale unfold one of the strangest that have ever been narrated between the covers of a book. He himself, my lord, is a physical wreck from cobbler's weak chest. His submission is that he is of Mongolian extraction and irresponsible for his actions. Not all there, in fact. Gloom. Carrot barefoot. Pigeon-breasted, in Lasker's vest and trousers, apologetic toes turned in, opens his tiny moth's eyes and looks about him dazedly, passing a slow hand across his forehead. Then he hitches his belt sailor fashion and with a shrug of oriental obeisance salutes the court, pointing one thumb heavenward. Him the K.A. belly muchy fine knife. He begins to lilt simply. Really cool 111 chili. Lindy Pickfoot every night. KE2 chili. He is howled down. J. J. Omaloy. Hoggly to the populace. This is a lone hand fight. By Hades, I will not have any client of mine gagged and badgered in this fashion by a pack of curs and laughing hyenas. The mosaic code has superseded the law of the jungle. I say it and I say it emphatically without wishing for one moment to defeat the ends of justice. Accused, was not accessory before the act and prosecutrix have not been tampered with. The young person was treated by defendant as if she were his very own daughter. Green Chase F. F. Omaloy's hand and raises it to his lips. I shall call rebutting evidence to prove up to the hilt that the hidden hand is again in its old game. When in doubt, persecute gloom. My client, an innately bashful man, will be the last man in the world to do anything ungentlemanly which injures. 140. Or cast a stone at a gear who took the wrong turning when some dastard carrot, responsible for her condition, had worked his own sweet will on her. He wants to go straight. I regard him as the whitest man I know. He is down on his luck at present owing to the mortgaging of his extensive property at Agenda's Netum in faraway Asia Minor, slides of which will now be shown. To Blom, I suggest that you avoid a handsome thing. Bloom. A penny in the pound. The mirage of the Lake O.J. Kinnereth with blurred cattle cropping in clover hot carrot ease projected over the wall. Moses Degick, carrot, ferrotide albino, in blue dungarees, stands up in the gallery, holding in each hand an orange citron and a pork kidney. Z-L-U-G-A-C-Z. Horsley, Blake Trishgrasse, Berlin, W, 13. Opening parenthesis slash dot, Omaloy steps onto a lawyer plinth and holds the lapel of his coat with solemnity. His face lengthens, grows pale and bearded, with sunken eyes, the blotches of phthisis and hectic cheekbones of John S. Taylor. He applies his handkerchief to his mouth and scrutinizes the galloping tide of rose pink blood. J. J. Omaloy almost voicelessly. Excuse me, I am suffering from a severe chill, have recently come from a sickbed. A few well-chosen words. He assumes the abeen head, foxy mustache and proboscidal eloquence of Seymour Bush. W.H. N. The angel's book comes to be opened if aught as a pensive bosom has inaugurated a sphere infigured and of soul transfiguring deserves to live, I say, afford the prisoner at the bar the sacred benefit of the doubt. A paper with something lurid and on it is handed into court. Moon in court dress. Can give best references. Messrs. Callan, Coleman, Mr. Wilson, Melly J. P. My old chief Joe Cuff. Mr. P. P. Dillon, ex-Lord Mayor of Dublin Terrace, has moved in.